tonight. Oh, I've been waiting for this all day, and we are now officially underway. Grabs the puck here inside the offensive end. Turn that chance aside.
Oh, he reads the play really well to get out and aggressive to make that save.
Off the mask of the goaltender, boy, right between the eyes.
That's gotta hurt. I don't care how much equipment you have or how good the...
Oh, and it's broken up.
Oh, he's not gonna want to see that on the video. The defender just raced up and closed the gap to push the puck away.
Takes a couple of knocks and loses control. Great defensive effort breaking up the pass. Lots of time left in this period. The game is still scoreless. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Stays winning. That pass goes a little sideways. Here's a chance for the front. Great pass save. Vancouver's got a hold of it along the wall. Great defensive effort with the strip. The turnover. Here they come. Detroit's got a hold of the puck. Takes it across the blue line and uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. Here's a short pass to McGillney. Vancouver's looking to break out. Sends the pass over. Here's a shot. They score!
This is what happens when a guy gets puck focused. He's now chasing the puck. Pretty soon, he's two or three strides away from where he needs to be. Can't get back to the slot to defend what he should be.
The Canucks have drawn first blood here in the opening frame.
Relatively early first goal puts them in a nice spot here, moving into the last half of the period.
Nice job tying up his opponent.
Assisted by number 16.
Kicks on the pass. Slides the puck across to Nielsen. Goes to the middle. Shuts it down. A stop. Takes the feet at the back end. And now it's grabbed by Nielsen. Puts it up front. Quick pass to Pettersson. Big save.
Yeah, he makes a nice save here with the glove, as you mentioned. But he's able to hang on to it. That's a tough save from this position on the end. A great chance at one end. Moments later, it's in the other net. It didn't take very long.
Nearing the midway mark of the period, you can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. And play resumes as the puck is shot.
Goal.
Sends score it over to Dassey.
25.
Oh, down it down. This is by number
3. This is the by number 3. The scoring chance is not dangerous if he can't get the puck at the goaltender.
Oh, he'll feel that one. Detroit's got a hold of it against the wall. Dassey's got the puck in his own zone. Vancouver's got it now. Pass is right to the front. Buries it for the goal.
I always wanted to have a fast start. It's funny, you remember. One times his puck, the goalie almost gets there, but the pass is on his tape in the low slot, and he beats him clean.
The Canucks get a little breathing room here as they lead by one in the first.
They talked about getting off to a good start in the first period. Now that they've got the lead, they'll want to build off.
Detroit's won the draw.
Goal. Scored
takes
by
the
number
feed
17,
to the
Ryan Kessler.
Blocked it away. Nice defensive use of the stick there.
The goal. 9 minutes, 37 seconds.
And now he moves it quickly to Bure. Detroit's got the puck. takes the feed.
From the time that puck's delivered to find it, he can't see it, so he drops into the butterfly and hopes it hits him.
The Canucks have given themselves a two-goal lead, but why does everybody consider this the most dreaded lead in hockey?
I think because teams tend to get a little bit tentative. They're comfortable with the two-goal lead. Sedin's point streak has been a thing to behold. You start to get superstitious on a run. You do everything the same, you wear the same suit all the time.
Vancouver's still got time here in this first period to increase this lead. Receives the pass. Offside is the call, and we'll have a face-off just outside the offensive zone. More than half the period has expired. Vancouver's been the better team here over the last few minutes, increasing their lead to two. Moves it to Zetterberg. Centering pass! Centered on in front! Scores! And right
back to the answer. You have to be able to respond to moments that happen that aren't very favorable to you. They give up a goal, and they go down the line. A quick flick of the wrist, and that snapshot beats the goaltender. He's in the low slot. He doesn't have much time to think about it.
Cooper's execution has been on point so far here in this first period. Puck is dropped and we are back underway.
Scored by number 40, Elias Pettersson.
That's just textbook positioning to break up the play. Sends it over to Kessler. That pass doesn't go.
12 seconds.
Kolstikov scoops it up here inside the defensive zone. Here's a short pass to Kessler.
quickly as they grind away till that opening shows up, and that's the one-timer from the low slot.
In the final moments of this period, Detroit's shown a new energy over these last few minutes. They got one back, but they still need one more in order to tie.
Red Wings goal!
Quick feed to Gatsu. Not able to connect.
Scored by number 9.
Touch the pass.
40!
Contact on the pass. Detroit's got control right now here on the offensive end.
And by
the steal of the play.
Eiserman!
Time of the goal, 19 minutes.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. Detroit's got it and they're on the attack. And that shot goes nowhere as the lane was filled. There he is, he's got to stop. Big save. Another pass for Arnold, but that was impressive.
Yeah, great, good, nice save, pal.
And that'll do it for period number one. No shortage of offense. Woo. I'm exhausted after that.
Did you know that season ticket holders get special discounts and access to insider information? Check our website for details.
Second period still to come. We'll take a quick pause and be right back with more action. Things up here to start this second period.
Nobody seems to be able to get the upper hand here. I've been really impressed with how well played this has been.
Red Wings goal. Score by
the puck
number
center.
9. Corey Howe.
Slaps it back to the lead.
By number 9. And by
number
4.
And now he moves it to center. Can't find his man. Puck picked up by Burrett. And he slides it quickly to Sedin.
Peterson.
They've got the defense outnumbered. And that's broken up with a stick in front. Nice solid entry from the left. Oh, he'd like to have that pass back. Gives them nothing in front.
Now, by being in the right position, James, to get so tight to the shooter, there's nowhere for the puck to go.
More than half the period left to play. We are all tied up in this one. Detroit's got it in the defensive zone. And he's ridden off the puck. Passes over to Lidstrom. Right in front! Scores! The go-ahead goal!
Now this game has been tight. Now somebody's got a leg up. Oh, shooter puts his own rebound away. That's a nice play. But man, the goalie burped this rebound out, made it way too easy for him.
Detroit's given themselves control of this game now with a one-goal lead in the second.
They'd like to get another before they go in for the second intermission. You'd love at least a couple-goal lead going into period three.
Skull scored by number 25.
The Canucks pull it on the board.
This is
he was
by number
93.
And by number 5, Naslund.
Denied by the goaltender.
9 minutes, 25 seconds.
Here they are on the attack. Sends it over, and they can't connect. Detroit's gained possession along the boards. Too many bodies in the way. Taken along the wall by Snaps. Swap up. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Puck sent over to Datsyuk. They've got numbers. It's a 2-on-1. Moving front, and they can't convert on the play. Moves it quickly over to Salo. From his own end, he moves it up ahead.
Love the way he moved that puck up quickly.
And makes the save. Slides the puck across to Dexter. From the right wing, he moves it to the middle. Huge steal in his own end. Here's a short pass to Sedin. Now a quick pass to McGillney. Oh, the check to slow down. The Red Wings look to start the transition game. Kicked up ahead to his teammate who skates away. Skates to the crease. Here's an offensive chance. Turns him away. And he slides it quickly to McGillney. And now it's over to Zadora. He's got a step, and he comes up with a big stop.
Can't do it better than that, James. That's a great stop.
Vancouver's got a hold of it along the wall. Right in the slot. Here's a shot. Denies him in front. Lidstrom's moving the puck through his own zone. A block! And the traffic jam in front blocks the shot. The Canucks gain possession along the wall. Tried to make a move and the puck hops away. Vancouver's looking to break out of their own end. Here's a chance. Puck grabbed by Bertuzzi. Came up with the save on that play. Sends the pass over. Here comes the push back.
Sure, the building is pretty loud after that last fight.
Both teams lined up in the face-off circle after the ice was finally decluttered moments ago.
Face-off is the number 16.
And we are back on the line
for fighting.
That's it, fly! Left save made by Good.
Last minute of play.
Slides it diagonally to Neal. Takes the feed. Vancouver's got a hold of it against the wall. Right in the slot, and they can't connect. Knocked away. Play whistle dead because of an offside. Canucks have had their chances, but they still trail late in the second. And there's the horn ending period number two. Boy, no shortage of offense here.
Fans, tonight, the home team Blimp is dropping $50 gift certificates to Delvin. Proud sponsor of tonight's game. With 70 stores and 14 restaurants, Delman's has it all.
And we'll be right back for what should be a very intriguing third. Vancouver's got the puck along the wall. Here's a short pass to Sedin. They go on the attack from center. Uses the force on that hit. And they can't connect. Icing the call. They get burned on the play here, Ray.
This is the responsibility of the centerman now. You're tired. Your guys around you are tired. You have to bear down and find a way, at the very least, to tie the draw so the offensive team doesn't get a big advantage.
The Red Wings take possession off the faceoff.
A one faceoff allows a clean breakout out of your zone.
Driving right to the front, and he gets a paddle on that one. McGillie's picking up steam. Look out!
Is waved off. I gotta believe this is goalie interference.
Well, he seems pretty firm waving that off immediately as soon as the light was lit up. Play set to resume, and you can see they're still frustrated by that non-goal call. This neutral zone faceoff set to go, and we are back underway. And he was right there, and they can't connect! And that's picked off in front. Kolesnikov plays it now. Picks off the pass. And couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. Detroit's ready to go on the attack. Right in the low spot. But loses it. No room for that one to get through. Oh, boy. Here comes a 3-on-1. Trying to get back on the attack now. Quick pass to Lindsay. Can't connect. And fight for it along the board. Nice punch inside the attacking zone. From the left side, they enter the offensive zone. Almost lost the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. Vancouver scores! We're all tied up!
Well, it's getting to a stage in the game where you think you're not going to be able to find the equalizer, but they stay up and they get it done. About 5 years ago, they started to pull the goaltenders a little earlier. The coach makes a good call here. He gets his keeper out. And now they're able to punch through with their net empty.
Vancouver's late third period goal certainly opens up a lot of decision-making for the coaches, doesn't it?
It does, but they must feel pretty good about their position because they just scored. By number I expect they got a little bit of a layup, even though the game is tough.
And that pass goes awry. Moves the puck across to Sidora. Thank you. gets to get the puck over to Sidora. Getting a little too physical to maintain possession. Here they come on the attack. Part of a shot. He got all of it. Vancouver stained possession along the boards. And puts the puck close inside the offensive end. Moves it quickly over to McGinley. Can't connect. Detroit's got the puck now. Dishes it to Shanahan. Vancouver's got control of it now from their own end. Pins them against the boards as they battle for the loose puck. Manages to hang on. McGillney's got the puck. Detroit's got a hold of it along the wall. Gains the zone from the right side. The Canucks take possession in the defensive end. Big hit on the boards.
He uses the boards in perfect form here. He closes off the gap and runs them in.
Tries to feed it over to Lindsay. And it's a quick pass to Cronwall. And he easily stops that one. Vancouver's got a hold of it against the wall. Through the neutral zone now, picking up steam. And something's going off here as the ref's hand goes high in the air. Time for the official to pass down his sentence.
Pretty cut and dry trip on that play. Coaches will tell you, be careful with your stick, but you're trying to get the puck. Yep. I don't think a lot of times they do it intentionally.
The Red Wings with an all-important power play opportunity here.
Sometimes you have to wait for your chances. Other times they come on a gift
penalty. Number 40.
Come on, power play in overtime.
2 minutes for Trevi.
Under the penalty. Handles the puck. Just slide. They get it out of the defensive end. Detroit's got the puck along the boards. Here's a short pass to Shanahan. And down he goes as the puck goes free. And they'll get it out of the defensive end. And the goalie leaves his crease to play the puck. Receives the pass. The Red Wings play along the wing. What a steal in his own end. Can't make that one happen. Takes the puck as the clock ticks down on the penalty kill. Burrows plays it against the boards. Detroit's got the puck along the wall. Looking for space inside the D zone. Gets the puck in deep. The Red Wings fail to score, and overtime rolls on.
The timing of this power play was really important, obviously, in overtime, and they don't get it done, so we go back to even strength.
Quick feed to Dexter. That pass goes a little sideways. Trying to gain a step. Moves inside. Pucks it away to stay on the attack. Vancouver gained possession along the boards. Here's a chance, a 2-on-1. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. Takes the pass. Locks him. And they fail to go take to take. Tries to get the puck to Sedin. Centering pass. Shot. And that was stopped. Moving to the middle. Big save by the goaltender once again.
Right from the most dangerous area on the ice.
For the win. Stage of the game.
Yeah, they're all big now. Up near the blue line, he's got to get out.
The Red Wings have it against the wall. Vancouver's looking to break out of their own end. Quick pass to Hughes. Working the puck deep inside their own end. Slides it on over to Pedersen. Couldn't connect, although not exactly an ideal pass to begin with. Icing the call. Does that drive the coaches nuts here?
It depends. But when it's a missed pass, a lazy play, yeah, it does. If you're panicking and you're gassed, you just need to reset.
The setters will glide into the dot. Vancouver's got a hold of the puck. The Canucks will play it in their own end. Here's an off-man rush. To the trap. And that's stopped by the goaltender using his head this time. Denies it again. Slides it quickly to Shanahan. Vancouver's playmakers the difference here as they come away with the overtime victory.
Even see their coaches fist pump behind the bench. The overtime win always is a little sweeter.
In the meantime and in between time, he's Ray, I'm James. Good night.